From a point Q, the length of the tangent to a circle is 24 cm and the distance of Q from the center is 25 cm. Find the radius of this circle now. You need to find the radius of the circle. So let us draw a diagram. So you can take a circle with the center O and you take external point Q. So draw two tangents from Q. So these are the two tangents drawn from the external point Q. So what they have given? From a point Q, the length of the tangents to a circle is 24 cm. That means it is 24 cm. You take this as A and this as B. So then this also 24 cm only. Tangents are always equal. And the distance of Q from the center is 25 cm. From the center to Q, it is 25 cm. Okay. Then you need to find the radius. So you find out the radius. Radius OA. So in this diagram, so OA is perpendicular to AQ. This is theorem 10.1. So therefore this is 90 degree means you can apply Pythagoras theorem. OQ square is equal to OA square plus AQ square. OA square we need to find out. OQ square, you know, that is 25 square is equal to OA square plus AQ square is 24 square. Okay, so what is 25 square? What is 25 square? 625 is equal to OA square plus what is 24 square? What is 24 square? 576. 576. So OA square is equal to 625 minus 576. OA square, subtract this one. 15 minus 6, it is 9. So 79, huh? 49. So OA is equal to root 49. So OA must be 7 centimeter. OA must be 7 centimeter. So this option is, you can write the option 7 centimeter. This is the first option. Option A. Listen here. In the figure, TP and TQ are two tangents to a circle with center O. So that angle PQ is 110 degree. Then find the angle PTQ. The given diagram is like this. So the given, there is a circle with the center O and two tangents are drawn from the external point T. So TP and TQ. These are the two tangents drawn from the external point. So if you join this, so you will get a quadrilateral like this. Now all of you look at this. They have given this angle POQ as 110 degree. So this is 110 degree. Now you need to find out the angle PTQ. So you have to find out this angle. So now OP and PT are perpendicular. OP is perpendicular to PT. That is theorem 10.1. Radius and tangent are perpendicular. Similarly, OQ is also perpendicular to TQ for the same reason. So therefore, angle P is equal to angle Q. Both are equal to 90 degree. So this is 90 degree and this is 90 degree. Now this is a quadrilateral. Angleson property of quadrilateral, you know that. So you can write, so in quadrilateral, in OPTQ, in OPTQ, sum of all the angles, angle POQ plus angle OPT plus angle PTQ plus angle OQT plus angle OQT is equal to 360 degree. Angles and property of any quadrilateral. So this is a quadrilateral. You know that sum of all the four angles of quadrilateral is 360 degree. Here POQ it is given 110 degree and OPT you know it is 90 degree. PTQ, we need to find out PTQ right as it is, and OQT is also 90 degree. It is equal to 360 degree now. So what is that sum? 110 plus 90, 200, then 290. 290 plus PTQ is equal to 360 degree. So angle PTQ is equal to 360 degree minus 290. So angle PTQ is equal to subtract, what is that? 70 degree.
70 degree.
70 degree. So that is the solution. The option here, option here B. B is the correct answer. Remember that always these two angles are supplementary, because 90 degree and 90 degree, they are 180 degree, then remaining 180 degree. Therefore, you remember these two. Angle POQ and PTQ is always supplementary. Just use that property. POQ plus PTQ is equal to 180 degree, hence it is 70 degree. So directly also you can write, but we use the property of a quadrilateral, then you have found out. The given question is like this: if PA and PB are tangents drawn from tangent from a point P to a circle. So you can draw a circle, and let us take P is a point, external point. So then, so this is A and this is B. PA and PB are two tangents to a circle with the center O. You can write this is center O. So then they are inclined to each other at an angle of 80 degrees. The angle between these tangents, this is 80 degree. Now the question is, find the angle POA. Angle POA, this angle. Angle POA, this angle we need to find out. So let us join this also. You can join this one. Okay, so how to find this angle POA? This angle, total angle is given. Angle POA, sorry, angle APB, angle APB plus angle AOB must be 180 degree, because the other two angles are 90, then the total quadrilateral property. So therefore APB here 80 degree, then AOB must be, AOB must be equal to 180 minus 80, that is 100 degree. So you got this total angle 100 degree. And you know that this line segment will bisect the central angle also. So we know that from the theorem 10.2, theorem 10.2 says that, so OP bisects angle AOB, because these two triangles are congruent. So these two angles must be equal. Angle AOB will be bisected, this line bisected by the line segment OP. So therefore you can write POA, angle POA must be half of angle AOB. So that means half of 100 degree. So it is 50 degree. Angle POA is 50 degree. This must be 50. So the option here, the first one, A.